Okay, back 6 or 7 years ago when I did my plywood box series, I showed my milling technique, and just in the last few days I've had several inquiries about that, saying it was confusing and didn't make much sense. And so I went back and looked at those videos, and they made sense to me, but I want to try to clarify it and maybe bring things into a little clearer perspective. And so I want to just concentrate on just one board, and we're going to just do one board, and I'm going to show how I mill this and how I mark it, and to keep things straight. Now, maybe I think what is confusing for people is the way I mark this is I'm marking it based on grain direction, not on feed direction. And so maybe that's what's confusing to people. So here with the joiner is moving this way into the workpiece. And so you want to have the grain laying down instead of trying to push it into the grain. So let's look at this piece of white oak, and let's see if we can't determine the grain here. So I'm looking at this, and I'd say the predominant direction is this way, like this. So I want the cutting barrel to be cutting like this instead of into the end of those fibers where it could lift and tear a hunk out. So that's the first thing that I look at. And after I face join this, I'm going to put a mark on it like this, and this is telling me that this is the direction of the grain that I'm going to keep track of. This is not the direction that I'm feeding the material through. This is the direction of the grain, and I just know that I feed from the opposite end. That's just my convention. It's just the way I've always done it. So let's join this board here first. There's my mark. So that's the direction that the grain is going. So I fed it like this. Okay, so I think this is the most confusing part for people. Okay, so we pass the jointer, we pass the material over the joiner this way, where the material is cutting like this. Now, to have it ready for the planer where the cutter head is on the top and the cutter head is moving like this, we need to all we have to do is just flip the piece around 180 degrees without turning it over. And now this is the direction of the grain for the planer. And this is how it's going to get fed into the planer. Even though we're feeding it in this way, my convention is I mark the grain direction. And you can see that the grain direction is in the proper orientation here the way we did it. So as the planer is cutting, the grain is laying down. We're not lifting into the grain where we're going to have a more likely chance of tearing a hunk off. So let's go to the planer now and let's pass this through. Okay, so I have the cowl flipped back on my Hitachi planer, and you can see here are the knives. The knives are going to spin this way. So the knife is coming into the work as the work is getting fed in. So that's the way it's cutting. So look again at our grain. So I'm going to feed the material in this way. This is telling me that the grain is running this way, and it's going to cut as the grain is laying down on top. We're not lifting anything and tearing a hunk out. Okay, let me put this cover back in place, and we'll make a cut. I'm going to leave the collector off, so it may blow out some dust, but I want you to be able to hear. Okay, so here's how I'm going to feed this into the planer. This may do it in one pass. And as soon as it comes out, I'm going to make this mark again, so then we can look at the two marks and see if that doesn't clear up some misunderstanding. So here is the direction that we ran that we say the grain is. We ran it through the planer like this. Now, what if we want to go ahead, since the planer does a much finer finish, it's spinning at almost 11,000 RPMs, does a much finer finish than the joiner, which is slower and is more for just flattening. You can see maybe that there's a little bit of planer ripple here. So this is the way we fed for the planer. Let's go ahead and clean up the other side. So all you have to do now is just flip the piece end for end, and you can see that the grain is still running in the proper manner. So let's pass this and clean that up. Well, I hope this makes sense. It's just my convention, the way I do it, but a lot of times I don't even have to mark this. I will do one, and then I just stack all my material up. And so say I've joined a whole bunch of boards like this, I just stack them all up at the orientation in which they come off the joiner, and then I just take the whole stack and I flip it around, and then I know I'm ready to pass it through my planer in the proper direction. Okay, so let's just continue this idea here, and let's make this piece S4S, and we're going to use the planer and not and just reinforce this idea. So here I'm looking at the grain again. So now you have two absolutely parallel sides. They're flat and they're parallel. Now let's look at the grain again for us to edge join. And here I'm saying that the grain is running like this. So in this case, I want to feed the material like that. Well, this is my grain direction here. So on this edge, I want the cutter head to lay that grain down. So let's pass this and get that cleaned up. So there's our mark right there. Back to our convention, we're like this. Now the way we're gonna run this through the planer, so my planer does a fantastic job standing material up on end. It just does a great job making things almost a finished edge ready for sanding versus, the table saw is faster, but I just wanna do this on the planer to reinforce. So we have the grain direction running this way. That's our mark, our convention. So all we have to do to have it ready for the planer now is just flip it like this. And this is the direction of the grain, and we're gonna feed through the planer like this. So let's go back over to the planer again. Okay, so here's our grain direction mark ready for the planer. And this may take a couple passes to get that knocked down. We'll see. I think that'll go. So here's my grain direction. This is the way I'm going to pass it through. I just flipped it around because I was just using that feeler gauge to see if I was going to bind. I may be able to do this in one pass. So again, that makes perfect sense. You know, the grain is running in the proper direction. You know, you can see it running down like this. And now say we want to let this be down on the planer platen and do the other edge. So we just flip it end to end this way.
Well, I hope this helps. It's very confusing, so it takes a while to just kind of get it through your own head how to do it. But I hope that my marking convention and will help you get this problem solved for your shop. Well, thank you. Bye.